Hi, good day. Welcome once again to Christianity 247. I hope you've been watching all the other videos, and I pray that the Holy Spirit will give you the strength and the ability to be able to understand and also practice what you have listened to. Today we are going to talk about how to be wiser than the children of this world. How we, the children of light, can be wiser than the children of the world. I want to take my reading quickly from the book of Luke. Luke chapter 16, from verses 1 to 8. I won't talk much today, because I believe the verse I'm going to read is very, very self-explanatory. It's about the unrighteous steward. And he said also unto his disciples, there was a certain rich man which had a steward, and the same was accused unto him that he had wasted his goods. And he called him and said unto him, how is it that I hear this of thee? Give an account of thy stewardship, for thou mayest be no longer a steward to me. Then the steward said within himself, what shall I do? For my Lord taketh away from me the stewardship. I cannot dig, I cannot beg. To beg I am ashamed. I am resolved what to do, that when I am put out of the stewardship, they may receive me unto their houses. So he called every one of his Lord's debtors unto him, and said unto the first, how much owest thou unto my Lord? And he said, 100 measure of oil. And he said unto him, take thy bill and sit down quickly and write 50. Then said he to another, and how much owest thou? And he said, 100 measures of wheat. And he said unto him, take thy bill and write 80, that is 60. And the Lord commended the unjust steward because he had done wisely. For the children of this world are in their generation wiser than the children of light. I stop there. The story is about an unrighteous steward that is working for a master. And the story shows that the man was being very, very unjust in his stewardship to his master. Why would you have a worker? You heard that the worker was doing things wrongly, maybe taking your money. You now come and tell the worker, I don't longer need your services because my accounts are not balancing. They are not balancing. And then the steward sits down and calls all those people that are owing his master. This one was owing 100 measures of oil. And he said, reduce it to 50. Cheating his master more. The second one, 100 measures of wheat, he said reduce it to 60. And here is our Lord commending this kind of unjust act. And at the end he says that this steward was wise. The Lord is not approving of the fact that he was cheating his master. The Lord is commending his wisdom. And where is that wisdom? The wisdom is in the fact that his ability to sit, to think, and to reason out what he should do now to prepare himself to where he will go when he's no longer with his master. That is the wisdom God is commending. Not the acts. Not the fact that he's cheating his master. Because some people want to use certain scriptures and confuse you. That is, if you allow yourself to be confused. It is not the act that is cheating his master the Lord is commanding. It is the wisdom behind the fact that he sat down. He looked at his environment where he was. He thought of what he can do where he was. So that he can prepare himself to where he will be when he's no longer where he is. And the Lord said, this kind of person that is doing things according to the way of the world has more wisdom than us that are in the world but are not of the world. How are we then preparing ourselves to where we are supposed to be after now? That is where the wisdom that God is commending comes in. You that is listening to me, have you sat down where you are? And have you reasoned out and thought, I am not of this world. I am of the kingdom of God, as long as you profess to be a Christian. What can I do where I am in order to prepare myself to where I will be? God calls that wisdom. Are you a businessman or a businesswoman? Are you a trader? Are you even working for somebody? Or do you own your own business? Or are you even working for a government establishment? Or perhaps you're just a housewife or a student? Have you sat down one day and asked yourself, what can I do where I am in preparation to where I will be? There is always something to do in the kingdom. There is always something to do. Because before God brought you, the Bible says that he has ordained every single day of your life. Before God created you, he has already put inside of you what you should do on earth for the advancement of his kingdom. What you can do to prepare yourself for where you're going. You know why many people are afraid of death? They're afraid of death because they feel they cannot go and give account of the time God gave you. Most times when you walk, if you go to a cemetery and you see on each cemetery, they normally write the date of birth and then there's a dash and then they'll write the date of death. The problem is that small dash. That small dash shows the time you were given to be on earth. What did you do with it? That time is different for everybody. And that measure, God already measured before he brought you to earth. This is the Bible. That time you're given is already given before you're even brought to earth. What have you done with it? Please, my dear Christians out there, stop wasting time. Get up and be wiser than the children of this world. You have a heavenly wisdom. Start using it. Don't feel there's nothing you can do. There is. Even if you feel you don't know what you can do, ask. That is why you have the seal of the Holy Spirit on your forehead as a Christian. That is why you have the Holy Spirit in you. He's there to open your eyes and show you what you can do. So, I pray that you will seek out the Holy Spirit and find out what you can do where you are for the advancement of the kingdom and also for the preparation of yourself for the kingdom of God. Thank you so much today for listening. And I pray that you got something today and you will start doing something from tomorrow in preparation for the kingdom of God. Thank you and remain blessed.